everybody. This video is going to describe the basic algorithm used for computing Boolean operations in a geometric modeling system. For the purposes of this video, we're going to assume the system is using a boundary representation scheme to model manifold shapes. Boolean operators are a useful tool by themselves for merging shapes, but they also serve as a fundamental utility which can be used for creating more powerful and familiar features such as a boss, hole, slots, or a lip. Boolean operators are named after George Boole, who first recognized that the set operations union, intersection, and complement could be turned into an algebraic system with properties similar to those of the real numbers. However, it was John Dehn who gave us a geometric model for these set operations in the form of Venn diagrams. Modern modeling systems extend this idea using volumes instead of area to represent sets, allowing us to use the concept of Boolean operators in three dimensions. So the basic algorithm we're going to use looks something like the flowchart shown here. We will examine this in greater detail shortly, but the big picture is that given two shapes, either 2D or 3D, we must first find all intersections between the two shapes. Next, we'll break the shapes at all intersection locations into disjoint parts, and then we need to classify these regions. And finally, depending on the operation we wish to perform, we will choose which regions to keep and which to delete. We'll start out looking at the steps in 2D and then move up to 3D. Here we have two circular regions, one blue and one red. We start by finding the points of intersection between these two shapes and breaking the profiles at these points of intersection into disjoint parts. What we're trying to do is find the outside profile shape for the result of our Boolean operation. Having the shapes determined by their outer boundary parallels the 3D boundary representation model. Because geometric modeling systems typically represent curves parametrically, finding the intersection between two curves actually involves finding three things. We need to find the 2D or 3D point of intersection, as well as the parametric values on each curve. The parametric values can be used to break the curve into disjoint regions. Now it's time to classify these separate parts. We classify a segment based on its location relative to the other profile. That is, based on whether it is inside or outside of the other region. So if A and B represent the profiles of our two regions, then segments of A may be inside or outside of B, while the segments of B may be inside or outside of region A. This gives us four classifications: A outside B, A inside B, B outside A, and B inside A. For the circle shown here, determining the location is trivial. However, for a general profile shape, this is not so easy. One of the typical approaches is to create a ray, starting at a point on the segment we wish to test. We then extend the ray until it is completely outside the profile shape. Now, intersecting this ray with the region boundary, we just need to count the number of intersections. If we have an even number of intersections, the point is outside, and an odd number of intersections means we are inside. In the picture here, the point on top makes three intersections, so it is inside, while the second point has six intersections, so it is outside. The direction of the ray does not really matter. While you may get a different number of intersections, the even or odd attribute will remain the same. Finally, we have to decide which regions to keep and which to delete. This varies depending on the type of Boolean operation. Remember, we are only concerned with the outer boundary of the resulting shape. So for a union operation, we want to keep the regions A outside B and B outside A and delete the other two regions. For an intersection operation, we want to keep B inside A and A inside B. And finally, for the set difference operation A minus B, we want to keep A outside B and B inside A. For B minus A, we would just reverse that and keep B outside A and A inside B. So let's start with a 2D example. Here we have two profile regions, A and B. A is shown in blue and B is shown in red. And we want to compute the 2D Boolean operation A union B. Our first task is to find all points of intersection between the two profiles. In this case, there are six points of intersection. Breaking the profile at these locations changes the red profile from three segments into nine and the blue profile from nine segments into 15. The next step is to separate the segments into four categories: A outside B, A inside B, B outside A, and B inside A. This will require firing multiple rays and counting intersections. You can see the segments here broken up into their respective categories. And finally, since we're doing a union operation, we want to keep the segments of A outside B and B outside A, and discard the segments in the other two groups. When we put the kept segments together, we get the new profile shown here, which is the correct result of the operation A union B. Now let's move from 2D to 3D. Our strategy is identical. The main difference is we now assume our regions are volumetric shapes. Again, we will limit our description to manifold boundary representations, though many of the basic ideas would still apply to non-manifold shapes. We can start with intersections. The typical result of a surface-surface intersection will be a 3D curve. However, we also need to keep track of the corresponding curves in the parameter space of each surface. So along with the 3D curve, we have two 2D parametric space curves. The 3D surface-surface intersections should eventually join to form a closed loop where the two shape boundaries touch. Breaking up curves at intersection locations was trivial, but breaking up a face around intersection curves requires a robust face-splitting routine. You can see from this example that the two faces generate four surface-surface intersection curves, and these curves break the blue face into five separate faces. Our four classifications will still be the same, except now we're referring to inside or outside the shell of the other shape. And the connected regions to keep and delete are identical to the 2D case. We can still use a ray firing technique to determine point location inside or outside of each shell. Notice we don't need to test every face for location. If we test one face, we can usually propagate this status to adjacent faces, as long as we do not cross any intersection boundaries. So let's consider a 3D example. Here we have two shapes, a blue block-shaped figure and a green oval shape. We'll call the blue shape A and the green shape B. And we want to compute the Boolean operation corresponding to the set difference B minus A. We start just like before and find all the intersections between the two shapes. You can see that we're able to find 12 surface-surface intersection curves, which we can form into four connected loops. Now we need to use our face-splitting routine to break apart at all of our SSI boundaries and create disjoint shells. The blue shape and green shape both get broken into five disjoint shapes. Next, we classify these disjoint regions based on their location relative to the other shape. We can see that for shape A, two of the regions are outside of B, while three of the regions are inside B. For shape B, the large oval shape is outside of A, while the four rectangular shapes would be all be inside of A. Now to perform our Boolean operation B minus A, recall that we want to keep those regions of B outside A and the regions of A inside B. We can throw away the regions in the other two categories. Sewing the kept regions together results in the desired boundary for the shape B minus A. Clearly, all of our other desired Boolean shapes could be achieved by simply changing which regions we keep in this final phase. So we've described the basic algorithm and shown how this applies to both 2D and 3D Boolean operations. Hopefully you have enough information to understand the basics of this powerful modeling tool. As with most geometric modeling algorithms, there's a lot of special cases to consider which we've ignored in this video, such as tangency and non-manifold cases, but these do not alter the basic overall strategy. I hope you found this video helpful. You can see more of my math videos at www.mathforeveryone.info. Please feel free to leave comments and suggestions, and thanks for watching.